making a ball of plasma in a microwave like this one. Plasma is the fourth state of matter and is generally found in stars. Here are the materials you'll need. You'll need a lighter like this one. You need a box of matches. But we'll only use a single match. You'll need a base to seat the match. And I made mine by cutting off the tip of a block of triangular wood and drilling a hole right there. Just shallow enough and just wide enough so that it would seat the match comfortably. So it looks like this. The reason for this base is, well, you don't want to burn the bottom of the microwave, do you? So I place this in the center of the microwave. Keep this lighter handy. These plastic rings serve a very important purpose. That jar you see behind you? Well, what we'll be doing is putting this jar over the match. And a match in a closed space will burn oxygen. No oxygen means no fire, means no plasma ball. So, we take these rings here, and you place them around the wooden block. And try to space them evenly. I think that'll do. Now, for one of the really important bits, you'll need a jar. I'm using a glass jar. Acrylic would be better because acrylic stands up to the heat of the microwave very well. But I don't have an acrylic jar. So, here we have our jar, a lighter. One of the final things that you need is a fire extinguisher. Why? Well, there's going to be a ball of plasma floating right here in the jar, somewhere in there. And if it were to escape from the top of the jar, then it may burn this part of the microwave. It could catch the microwave afire. So, that's why you need a fire extinguisher. Another danger is that this reaction creates toxic gas. It has an acrid smell, and it's noticeable when you open the door of the microwave. Don't breathe it in. You want to be in a very well ventilated area. Fortunately, I am. Now, make sure the turntable is off, because obviously you've already taken it out, but you don't want the match spinning around. I'm going to time this for 20 seconds. That's more than enough time. Okay? I'm going to light this. Make sure the flame is burning well before you place the jar over it. Close the door and press start. Now, make sure your hand is on the kill button. You don't want to leave it going for more than a few seconds. Or the jar can break, like that. That's why you use an acrylic jar, people. Also, you want to make sure you let the jar cool before you open the door of the microwave. I couldn't really see, but if that entire jar shattered, then I have a mess to clean up. But if it didn't, and I open the door and let cool air rush in, that jar is going to shatter, and I'm going to have a mess to clean up. But as you saw, the plasmoid ball escaped from the top of the jar. That's the danger. Alright, I think it's cooled down enough now. that's good. That's good. That is how you make a ball of plasma in your microwave. I hope you enjoyed.